Okay, so you can create memory safe languages, done. You can also create exception safe languages, done. But can you create programmers safe languages? I don't think so. Sometime back, White House recommended programmers to make use of memory safe languages, the likes of C#, Go, Java, JavaScript, Python, etc. And since it came from White House, it's but obvious that people will take notice. Now, this particular debate has ignited again because of this Microsoft CrowdStrike outage that happened a few days back. One of the largest, if not the largest, outage in the IT history. And when the people tried to look into the root cause, and based on the information that is available on the internet, it seems to be a null pointer exception. Pretty trivial and basic exception that occurred, which generally happens when you write code in programming languages like C or C++. Even today, the kernels are written predominantly in C, so that could have been the case, but there is no official confirmation from CrowdStrike or Microsoft. But from the looks of it, this looks like to be the case indeed, but we are not talking about the root cause of this. This has ignited the debate once again about using a memory-safe language versus languages like C or C++. And I get it. I, as someone who has written code for 18 long years in C and C++, I know what the language is. I know how people perceive the language and what are the people's opinion on this. And I also know that why people are jumping on the bandwagon, because something has happened which shouldn't have happened, but maybe giving a lifeline to what someone thinks. That's the unfortunate part, because we are not trying to look into the root cause just because it suits a particular narrative. So let me get into the root cause of it. I don't think it's a null pointer exception. A very simple and small unit test case written for the code that was deployed could have prevented this. And I believe it is the dumbness of the programmers. Sorry for the language, but you know, stupidity of the programmers who are writing the code, because we are just reducing the bar again and again and again, because we think that we are going to use a language which is going to take care of the mistakes of the programmers. That's not the case. Let me tell you one thing, one surprising fact. I wrote code in C++. I never ever faced any memory issue or memory leakage issue, especially when I was using the STL. But I faced memory leakage issues and memory not being cleaned issues with my programs in Java and C#.NET. Of course, I was dependent on garbage collectors, but you know, it wasn't working. And if you have ever created a production level Java or C# or .NET code, you know there are memory issues. But when these programming languages came into picture, they were advertised as, you know, some kind of magical thing which will take care of all the memory related issues. That didn't happen. Okay, so if you are keep on having dumb programmers writing the code, you will keep on getting into these kind of situations. There are a lot of talk about, you know, memory safe languages. Okay, go ahead and use it. If you are not writing the code in a proper way, you'll get into problems. You can create exception safe languages, but what next? Are you going to create divide by zero safe languages? And you know that irrespective of the language, if you are accessing an array, the array out of bounds can happen. So what you are going to do? An array subscript safe language? That's what you are going to create? There is no end to it. Since I'm programming for a very long time, let me tell you that every language provides you some powers. And with great powers come great responsibilities. Not my dialogue, it's Spider-Man's. So, you know, C and C++, they gave individual programmers a lot of power, but it has to be used with responsibility. You cannot just give a power to a programmer without installing a sense of responsibility in them, where they are not blindly dependent on test cases written by someone else, some QA done by someone else, some AI, some tools. No. A programmer needs to understand that he or she has to take care of pretty much everything. And that's how programming is done. So the crux is, move to whichever language you feel comfortable with, because close to 90-95% or even more than that, things can be done in pretty much all programming languages. move to the language of your choice, but be a responsible programmer. That's all I wanted to talk today. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. See you again.